You mean you think I could end up being as good as my dad if I keep practicing?
Your dad? Your dad was probably the best whack bat player we ever had in this school. No, you don't want to have to compare yourself to that.
No, but I think I have some of the same raw natural talent, don't you?
You're improving. Let's put it like that.
I'm going to take another look at Fantastic Mr. Fox in a week or two. My son did a third grade book report on the Roald Dahl story, and he's interested in checking out the film version, as are presumably a few other kids and a lot of adults as well. First time I saw it, I found myself right down the middle on this picture. A lot of it's charming, especially in the old-fashioned stop-motion animation, and it's certainly more adventurous than most of the animated features we see in any given year. And yet, I found it a little arch. No surprise there, really. Fantastic Mr. Fox was co-written and directed by Wes Anderson. He made the bittersweet comedies Rushmore, which I love, The Royal Tenenbaums, and most recently, The Darjeeling Limited. He's taken the Roald Dahl storyline about a sly fox engaging three nasty farmers in a life-and-death battle for survival and filled it out with all sorts of family complications. Mr. and Mrs. Fox, voiced by George Clooney and Meryl Streep, have a son, Ash, voiced by Jason Schwartzman, whose visiting cousin is causing him all sorts of angst about his self-image and his relationship with his own father. Mr. Fox in the movie is far more of an arrogant wiseacre than the more conventionally heroic figure in the book. That's not a bad thing in itself, but I think if you find yourself a little cool toward Anderson's movie, which was co-written by Noah Baumbach, the reason might be because these changes and additions aren't entirely satisfying. Still, Anderson's film is a meticulous visual achievement. A lot of people love it.
I like your ears.
Mine?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. I like your spots.
Really? I used to cover them up, but, you know.
You're supposed to be my lab partner.
I am.
No, you're not. You're disloyal.
So, see where you land for yourself, why don't you? 2.5 stars for Fantastic Mr. Fox. For the Chicago Tribune, I'm Michael Phillips.